RAID stands for Redundant Array of Independent Disks. RAID technology allows you to create a storage unit using multiple hard drives. This unit, called an array, can be used to improve performance or increase fault tolerance. Let's explore the different RAID types. RAID 0, also known as striping, works by distributing the data of a single file across multiple disks. By making several drives work together simultaneously, it improves read-write performance. Instead of relying on a single disk for operations, tasks are parallelized across all drives. However, since RAID 0 links disks in a series, the failure of even one disk results in the loss of all data. RAID 1, or mirroring, uses multiple redundant disks where each drive in the array contains an identical copy of the data. Writes occur simultaneously on all disks so that any disk can replace another. This redundancy increases data availability because it can tolerate the failure of one disk. RAID 5, or striping with parity, combines data striping, as in RAID 0, with distributed parity. Each stripe consists of data blocks and a parity block. If a disk fails, any missing data block can be recalculated using the parity block and other data blocks. This ensures data integrity. It can tolerate the failure of one disk at a time. Read performance is enhanced thanks to striping, but write performance is slightly slower due to the parity calculations. If a disk fails, the RAID controller deactivates it and can rebuild the mirror after the faulty disk is replaced. Read performance is improved because operations can be parallelized, but write speeds remain standard due to the simultaneous duplication process. RAID 10, also called striped mirrors, creates distinct mirroring zones, as in RAID 1, that are interconnected via striping, as in RAID 0. With this configuration, it's possible to lose up to 3 disks simultaneously, one in each mirror, without data loss. It provides excellent read-write performance and high availability, but is one of the most expensive RAID configurations in terms of cost. RAID 50, or striping of RAID 5 arrays. It combines striping, RAID 0, with multiple RAID 5 subsystems. Each node relies on a RAID 5 setup, allowing RAID 50 to significantly increase storage capacity and fault tolerance. In summary, RAID 0 is best for applications requiring large file transfers and maximum performance, with no need for fault tolerance or redundancy. RAID 1 is ideal for applications needing a small amount of data with a strong focus on high availability and data redundancy. RAID 5 is suitable for applications requiring high read-write performance with a balance of fault tolerance, often used for file servers or databases with moderate data volumes. RAID 10 is perfect for applications demanding high performance, low latency, and high availability, such as transaction-heavy databases. It's the most costly option in terms of storage efficiency. Finally, RAID 50 is suited for large-scale databases or applications requiring a balance of high performance, large storage capacity, and fault tolerance. If you enjoyed this video, hit that subscribe button to stay in the loop with my upcoming content, and don't hesitate to share it with anyone who might find it useful. See you soon!